I just
okay.
I just have two questions for Samit. One, that why is it that we were able to do things in 49 days, at least initiate an SIT? Why is it for 9 months, BJP sitting quiet on it, wakes up only before elections and does a selective leak? Please come clean. Number two, what is it that is there in the committee report saying that Justice Mathur has recommended an SIT means nothing? Now, Justice Nanavati also, his commission recommended SIT for 4 of the cases. How many? 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. How many cases has Justice Mathur asked? Please come clean on it as to the SIT is for all 237 pending cases which have been closed or just a handful like Justice Nanavati.
Well, Dr. Patra, your turn. Sabha's question, Rahul Mehra, and all pointing to the same direction. Is it hypocritical or is this a genuine effort?
First to Sabha, let me say Sabha feels that Bharatiya Janata Party probably would not carry out justice for most of the SITs, will not carry out justice for the kind of riots that the country has seen. Sabha, let me with all my respect tell that people of this country I consider are the most secular people of the world. And if they have chosen this government with the kind of mandate that we have seen, they have chosen because they believe that this government is the one which will deliver justice on most of the fronts, not only on the fronts of economy and other issues,
but also on
the front of communal versus secular battle. Because time has passed with this secularism boogie.
By that argument,
Sabha, you are an eminent journalist. Please don't interject. All I wanted to say was, look, it is not just the Congress party which should go to the Antony report. I believe the Aam Aadmi party should also borrow the Antony report from Congress, their cousin brother, and should please browse through, should go through the Antony report. Secondly, as far as my friend Rahul Mehra's question is concerned, Bharatiya Janata Party does not make irresponsible statements. We, in fact, make statements, we make commitments only after thorough study of the affair. Though I'm not preempting whether an SIT would be formed or not, if at all it is formed, it is because of recommendation by the wisdom of a justice called Mr. G.P. Mathur. So I believe the wisdom of a justice should not be questioned. Thirdly, adding to Rahul Mehra, yes, Hartosh Bhatt.
Look, the issue
no,
is,
I want to. I want to rebut Samit first.
My right was.
I want to
no,
rebut
let
Samit
me,
first.
Can let,
I
let me have my word, Sabha? Sabha, let me finish no, what I'm saying.
Let me just rebut.
Let me make
Samit
my point,
first.
Sabha.
By that logic,
this is not about Sabha. This is more important. This is not about my right versus your right. This is simply a question of getting justice for particular incidents of violence which were orchestrated by a political party. I'm perfectly fine if in this game of competitive politics in this country, justice is delivered for any one particular incident. But in this case, you have to note, people were killed for the sake of votes. Today, an inquiry is being ordered for the sake of votes. And let us not quote retired justices as authorities through leaked news reports. Some of those 9 reports, which are clearly wrong, were orchestrated by retired justices of this country. All of them are open to question. That is why timing, circumstances, the conditions under which inquiry is ordered is very important, and the BJP is playing around with that today.
And how is it that it does not get priority?
No, I want to just complete
answering
one point.
The question of who shared the voter list. How is it that they were able to pick and choose from various residences and various areas? Who handed them? Isn't it justice to our Sikh brothers in this country that 30 years they waited for the people that were killed? It was a massacre which happened over 3 or 4 days. And still, you're looking at the right opportune moment. It does not feature in the manifesto of one of the parties in the fray for the Delhi polls. It is somewhere down in the bylines of the manifesto of the other parties. How is it that it is not priority? That's the other question, sir. And that is why we try and question intent. Because it doesn't look like honest intent. It just looks like a political gimmick, an election gimmick, Dr. Patra. And I go back to Rahul Mehra's question that if an SIT notification had happened by the Delhi cabinet and it had gone up to the LG of Delhi and it was also okayed by him, all that required was the official notification by the LG and setting up of the SIT. 6th of February 2014, between 16th of May 2014, after your government was formed, after Delhi went to President's rule, you had the option to do it then. Why wait till December to decide that, okay, we'll set up another retired justice to decide whether or not an SIT should be there, whether or not there should be more probe? These are the questions that come to mind. I mean, are you serious about giving those people closure? Or do you feel that doling out some more money is enough to keep them quiet for some more time?
Anand, my simple answer to all these questions, I mean, you told her a collective rebuttal would be two words of Hindi, you know, hangama kyun hai, barpa chori to nahi ki hai na. Why are we all fighting? We are talking of justice.
Log maut mare hai.
Where are
they? Bemaut mare gaye hai sadkon pe.
Just a second.
Unko bahar khech khech ke nikal ke talwar ki dhar se kaata gaya hai.
Just a second.
Logo ko pakdaya gaya hai hathode.
Just a second.
Talwaren pakdayi gayi hai truckon se, aise diya gaya hai. Sab documented hai. Everybody knows what happened.
Just a second.
Everybody knows who did it. But nobody wants to pull them up and put them behind bars and make them accountable.
Just a second.
इसीलिए हंगामा बढ़ पाया सर.
We are talking of justice. Why are you so afraid of justice? We are the ones who, in fact, had started the game of justice when none
of it's not a game, sir. It's not the game of justice. Please don't call it a game.
Kumar was okay.
It was a process which should have been pursued relentlessly.
Allow your guests to complete. You do not interject other speakers. Did you interject Hartosh Bal or the Aam Aadmi Party spokesperson?
Go ahead, Dr. Patra.
You should not be interjecting.
Go ahead, Dr.
Patra. Bharatiya Janata Party is speaking.
Please don't call it a game of justice.
We have the intention of justice, and justice should not shout. I am pained that today justice has to shout. Are we not the ones who brought, in fact, Jagdish Kumar Taitla, the Sajjan Kumars of Congress to the book? We were the ones who saw to it that FIR were registered. The Aam Aadmi Party was not even born in the galaxy of politics then. So what is the Aam Aadmi Party trying to do? The Aam Aadmi Party should stop politicizing every issue of this country. The Aam Aadmi Party should stop deriving opportunistic gains
out of every
incident that is taking place in this country. And thirdly, where are the rightiers? Why are the rightiers not in the debate today? In fact, if someone should have been pulled, then they are the right ears. The Congress should have been present in the debate. And
the Congress walked out of the debate, sir.
Today.
And I'll put it
not
on record. The Congress walked out of the debate,
True.
Sir. Just before the debate got underway, the Congress board walked out of the debate. And I'm putting it here on record here on this broadcast. Yes, Rahul Mehra.
Anand, I don't want to hear discourses about political naivety from somebody like Samit Patra, who makes a mockery of every debate. You know, he must restrain himself. We might be just 2 years old.
The biggest mockery of politics in this country is Mr. Arvind Kejriwal. Don't go personal,
and because of
whom, I'll also start talking about Arvind Kejriwal, Mr. Rahul Mehra.
Please stop it. Please, I'm requesting you.
No, why stop it?
I'm requesting you. You keep on saying don't interject when others interject. When you are speaking,
you are in a habit
of interjecting.
You are not. You Anand,
please ask Dr. Patra to stop interjecting.
The Aam Aadmi Party was not even born when Nerula Commission, Nanavati Commission.
Wait,
the Aam Aadmi Party is around here now.
Nowhere to be seen. Now let Rahul Mehra make his point. You have given your time. Let him also make his point now, please.
Anand, this is the arrogance of power. You know, with power, you should be there should be
this
humility.
This is not the arrogance of power. This is the right of showing both the people who make personal allegations. If you make personal allegations, then I will surely shout on Arvind Kejriwal, who is the biggest liar of Indian politics and the biggest scam of the century.
Hold on, Dr. Patra. Yes, Rahul Mehra. Yeah, please get to the point.
Okay.
Yeah. Go ahead, Rahul Mehra.
All I'm saying is, Anand, when Sabha was interjecting and trying to make her point, Samit Patra was getting very offensive. And you just saw in the last 1 minute what he's been doing. The moment I start, his running commentary starts.
Let's get back to the debate.
Mr. Mehra, if you have a point related to the debate, let's quickly get to that.
To the extent I can. So all I was saying was that, you know, it's about the intent. It's not about making a particular issue a political issue out of genocide. You know, if we could do it in 49 days, if we can have a manifesto in which we have this as a very major issue for us, if we can prioritize, if we being just 2 years old and not a 40-year-old mega party which has been voted into power by the people of India, yes, I agree we are 2 years old, but we don't want to fall in the trap of the 40-year-old politics of BJP to the 60-year-old politics of Congress. We want to change that political discourse, which is why this political party has taken birth.
Right.
So I'm proud of the fact that we don't follow the
you know,
the
Rahul Mehra, the questions
the
that are being raised for BJP
and Congress,
are the same
which are totally
for you
anti-Sikhs.
Right, point taken, but the questions remains the same for all the political parties in Sabha. And Hartosh, this question is for you. Do you think this is just going to remain when it comes to riot politics and that's all it's going to be? If justice has to be done, it will come out from the legal courtrooms if it ever does. Sabha, you go first.
Yes, I certainly think so. And I mean, even legal systems are manipulated, which is why justice is not delivered for the people of the 1984 riots and subsequent riots. But I want to say one thing. You know, Sambit said that the country has given its answer through secularism, and the answer is given, we are the party that gives justice. I just want to say one thing. After the horrific violence in Delhi, the Congress won many, many elections. And so has the BJP done after violence. But that does not mean that things which are enshrined in our constitution, values that we were born, we all believe in, that they can ever be forgotten. That electoral victory can be thrown at the face of those who will continue to ask questions. We cannot do that. And that is no justification for anything. That is all I wanted to say to Sambit.
True. Sambit Patha coming to you. Yes, Hartosh Bal, the other fact is, that don't those lives and don't those people matter to the polity, because the Sikhs don't constitute more than 5 to 6% of the 1.8 crore odd population of Delhi and part of the entire voter jung. That's why it has become a minority or a subtext as far as manifestos, and some of the manifestos it doesn't even feature. Doesn't it pain you that 30 years down the line those scars remain, but people are they want to layer it and they just want to rub it a bit and scratch it around the elections. That's what irks us the most, because if the intent was there, closure would have happened long time back.
See, one, I want to preface this by saying language is important. Let's not call it a riot. Several people here have been doing that. Identifying people, disarming them, picking them out from their houses, burning them to death by identified lists is not a riot. It's a government-sponsored massacre. Let us be honest, a Congress-sponsored massacre. And there has been a derailment of justice for 10 commissions, including by many retired Supreme Court justices, despite what Sambit Patra says. In these circumstances, if today suddenly the BJP wants to institute an inquiry in the run-up to the elections or announce it through leaked reports, it is because while, yes, the Sikhs are a minority, this is a close election, those 5% votes matter. Apart from that, I don't think the BJP has any more sympathy for the Sikhs than the congressmen who massacred them did. Let's not be under these illusions, but let us be clear about the games are playing, that are being played, call them out and insist maybe 4 weeks after the elections that these people live up to what they are promising now.
Well, we'll hold them to account. Whoever sits on the seat of Delhi will be held to account, and we will ask them the questions first, because this should be our priority. Yes, Dr. Patra, coming to you, Raul Mehra. Yes, Dr. Patra.
Hartosh Bal says that sudden justice has emerged. I would say justice is always a gradual process. Justice is never sudden. And we have been fighting gradually on the streets right from the very beginning. And all of you know it, that Bharatiya Janata Party has been fighting the battle on this. I would not preempt, though, whether the SIT report is right or wrong, who leaked it, from where it got leaked. I do not know. I am not a game into all this thing. Thirdly, and very importantly, what I meant to say was, what I wanted to put over here is the Aam Aadmi Party tries to take the opportunity into everything.
No, wait, Sambit Patra, before you go at the Aam Aadmi Party, Hartosh Bal wants to interject.
What I meant,
please listen to what Hartosh has to say and then carry on, sir. Yes, Hartosh.
No, just a second. Hartosh can please ask me the question. All I wanted to say is, whatever time this would have come, the so-called leak, you say, whatever time this may have come, you always would have questioned me, because there was a Jharkhand election, there was a Maharashtra election, there was a Jammu Kashmir election. Some time or other, these 7 months, elections after elections were going on. So any time, and our Sikh brothers and sisters live everywhere in this country. So it's but natural that any time this news would have come up, though I am not preempting anything, anytime, surely you would have not lost the opportunity of hitting at BJP, because that's the chosen profession of many.
No, it's not about hitting at BJP, he's asking questions to everybody who's trying to use this as an election poll gimmick. Hartosh Bal.
Anand.
Coming to you, Rahul, he wanted to interject, then suggest going to Hartosh.
Unless Sambit Patra claims that Ram Jethmalani is a liar, I think there has been enough evidence that the BJP chickened out from fighting important court cases when they would have really mattered. This includes Advani and Vajpayee. The second point is, even in the selection of Nanavati, and Nanavati is alive today, so this can be conjectured, debated. Nanavati had already passed a judgment where he had expressed his opinion that the riots were not an organized massacre. It was after that he was made in charge of an inquiry commission, and he surprisingly came up with the conclusion that it was not an organized massacre. This is the BJP's idea of delivering justice. That is why their choice of who they will appoint to this commission, how the SIT will conduct this business, is open to scrutiny and is open to question.
Right, Dr.
Pandey. Right, Rahul Mehra. Yes, Rahul Mehra. Coming to Dr. Patra, we're going to wind up the debate, so let Rahul make his point and then we'll take the closing comments. Yes, Rahul.
Anand, the point I want to make is, let's just sit back and see as to what's happening over the last 45 minutes on your debate. We are saying that 38 years or 40 years, whatever, more than three decades, is good enough for justice to be delivered, and let's wait for another 20, 30 years because justice takes its time. It's a gradual process. All I'm saying is, if there is a political intent, A, this should have been stalled, and not the selective leak should have, if at all, should have come after 10th of February, not now. Two, why is it that we can't today, and why can't Samit Patra or the government today put a confined time limit that within the next 6 months, we will be either proceeding and going and reopening all 237 cases,
right,
or this country should stop debating about the 237 cases, and we shall not revisit and reopen this debate.
Have you put a timeline in your party's manifesto,
sir? We will not reopen and
revisit
these debates.
Have you put a timeline in your party's manifesto, sir? Have you put a timeline in your party's manifesto?
I am, as a spokesperson, telling you, we are committed to this issue.
No, what's
we
the
are the ones,
sir?
If we come
the
into power,
sir?
Which we are.
What's the timeline? Say 10th of February, 10th of February, the Aam Aadmi Party gets a mandate.
Sir,
I'm asking you, Rahul Mehra, 10th of February, if Aam Aadmi Party gets the mandate for Delhi, tell us the time frame. Tell our Sikh brothers and sisters right now watching this broadcast, what is the time frame by which you will get some concrete action happening, not promises and not just mere talk?
Allow me. We would request the SIT, you know, the moment it's constituted, that it should happen within the next 6 months to maximum 1 year. And we should stop debating and then start acting on it.
So when
and
the SIT is constituted,
cases,
will you make constitution of the SIT priority?
Reopen all 237 cases, not selectively. No, absolutely. I'm giving my commitment to you from my party.
Right, now we're going to wind up.
That's what Aam Aadmi Party is saying. Dr. Patra, quickly coming to you also. Is there a timeline that your government would want to keep to this, or we'll just keep going on and on about it until probably the next
6 months
elections?
To 1 year, all cases to be reopened, says the AAP, constitution of SIT priority.
Let me tell you, Anand, the world has seen that the Bharatiya Janata Party is the only party which was committed towards justice as far as Sikh brothers and sisters are concerned. Sir. We are talking of increasing compensation.
Oh,
we are
sir, no, sir, sir, what's the time frame?
Why are
the
others worried?
What's the time frame?
Why are the others worried? I don't understand.
No, sir, what's
if
the time frame?
If we are talking
frame,
of justice, if we are talking of compensation,
no,
why
no,
is
sir,
the
sir,
Aam
what's the time frame of just
today?
Notifying, constituting the SIT and initiating the probe across all the files? What's the commitment that you can give on behalf of the BJP if BJP gets
the model code of conduct is on. The model code of conduct is on. You very well know that even if a trap is laid, I will not fall into the trap. Because
no. Sir, it's a commitment as far as your manifesto. You have said that you will try and
that
bring closure.
That may be a leak.
What is the time frame?
But I would not play into a leak trap.
No, sir. I'm asking you, what is the time
justice
frame? What is the time frame that
if
your government will set itself? Will it give it priority? Will it say 6 months to 1 year we'll try and work towards closure?
Let me tell you, the GP Mathur committee was formed for 3 months, but within 45 days, the Mathur committee submitted its report. Similarly, if we constitute an SIT, which surely I believe with our commitment, we would do in the days to come, though I would not preempt the reports,
right,
but still I would say within few months, 3 months, we will see to it that justice at its best is delivered.
Right, gentlemen, and Sabha Naqvi, thank you very much for joining us on this special broadcast, winding up the debate on the note that come the 10th of February, whoever gets the mandate will be held accountable. No more options to go back to riot politics.